ओके हेलो टू एवरीवन माय क्लास सिक्स स्टूडेंट्स. सो वी वुड बी कवरिंग इन दिस वीडियो वन ऑफ आवर चैप्टर ऑफ सिविक्स व्हिच वाज नॉट बीइंग कंप्लीटेड इन माय प्रीवियस वीडियो. सो इट्स द सेकंड वीडियो ऑफ दैट चैप्टर. प्लीज डोंट गेट दैट कंफ्यूज्ड. आई एम नॉट स्टार्टिंग अ न्यू चैप्टर. आई एम जस्ट कंटिन्यूइंग अ प्रीवियसली लेफ्ट चैप्टर ऑफ सिविक्स एलिमेंट्स ऑफ डेमोक्रेटिक गवर्नमेंट. वी हैव लेट लेफ्ट दैट चैप्टर इन बिटवीन इन द प्रीवियस वीडियो बिकॉज इट वॉज बिकमिंग टू लेंदी. ओके so there were two points that were left to be discussed in the chapter. One was need to resolve conflict. Acha, let me recall what we have learned in that previous video. If suppose you are joining new to this chapter, humne usme ye sab cheez discuss ki thi ki as a people of democratic country, what are the ways that how can we keep our demands in front of government. Okay, so there were some few common terms by rallies, धरना, प्रोटेस्ट, हड़ताल इज ऑल्सो देयर. दो हड़ताल एंड स्ट्राइक्स आर नॉट अ गुड थिंग टू डू बट स्टिल इट थिंग्स आर मेंशन समवेयर समटाइम्स इन दिस चैप्टर. ओके, थ्रू न्यूज पेपर्स वी कैन कीप अवर डिमांड्स इन फ्रंट ऑफ गवर्नमेंट, थ्रू मीडिया, सोशल मीडिया. नाउ देर आर मेनी मेनी थिंग्स नाउ डेज. सो नाउ वी विल स्टडी कि वाई वी शुड रिजोल्व दिस कन्फ्लिक्ट. वट इज द मीनिंग ऑफ कन्फ्लिक्ट? कन्फ्लिक्ट मीन्स क्लैशिंग ऑफ टू आइडियोलॉजीज. जब दो लोगों के विचार आपस में क्या करते हैं, कॉन्ट्राडिक्ट करते हैं, क्लैश करते हैं, दैट इज कॉन्फ्लिक्ट. और रिजोल्व का मतलब क्या होता है? टू सॉर्ट आउट, टू गेट अ सोल्यूशन, गुड सोल्यूशन, ओके, बेटर रिजल्ट. सो वाई शुड गवर्नमेंट या वी एज अ पीपल रिजोल्व कन्फ्लिक्ट? वाई शुड गवर्नमेंट रिजोल्व अवर कन्फ्लिक्ट, अ डेमोक्रेटिक गवर्नमेंट? See, if we take example of our country, India. India is a huge, huge democratic country. People of different religion, different culture, people speaking different languages, okay, different traditions, sorry, live in our country, India. So it's a duty of our government, local government, state government, and central government to keep people binded together. There should be no conflict in between two different states people. If suppose people of two different states are living together, yeah, people of two different language speaking are living together, there should not be a conflict, a clash, a fight in between them for their eating habits, for their festivals, for their way of living. No. So it's a government role to intervene it in between. Okay, okay. Now moving to a bigger scenario, this is the thing that if something goes wrong on a smaller scale, अगर किसी बड़े लेवल पर कोई चीज बहुत ज्यादा आउट ऑफ कंट्रोल हो जाए, ओके, या यू कैन से इफ द स्टेट गवर्नमेंट इटसेल्फ डज समथिंग रॉन्ग, तो who is the authority in the country, who is the concerned person in the country who can take control over this state governments, who can keep a check on the state government. As the hierarchy says, then the supremest government in our country is central government, then it's state government, and then it's a local government. It's local government. If suppose a particular government starts behaving in a manner which is harming its people, अगर state government ही कुछ गलत decision ले ले, वो ही गलत तरीके से काम करना start कर दे, then who will cross check its work? Central government या central machineries will check the works of this particular thing. Like I give you an example, small example. कि द प्लेसेस द एग्रीकल्चर फील्ड्स विच आर नियर बाई टू द स्टेट बाउंड्री, जैसे आप लोगों ने देखा होगा या मे भी सुना भी होगा इन द न्यूज़ पेपर विच आर रीडिंग इन शामली, कि द एग्रीकल्चर फील्ड्स विच आर नियर टू यमुना रिवर, नियर द बॉर्डर ऑफ पानीपत, वेयर द बॉर्डर ऑफ हरियाणा एंड यूपी मीट्स. सो मैनी अ टाइम द रिवर यमुना, इट चेंजेस इट्स फ्लो कोर्स. जब मानसून होता है, वैन इट gets dried up, and when it again get water from different resources, many a time it changes its path. वो अपना रास्ता चेंज कर देती है. तो होता क्या है, द फार्मर्स हु आर डूइंग फार्मिंग इन द पर्टिकुलर एरिया वेयर द रिवर इज फ्लोइंग, देयर लैंड गेट्स डिसलोकेटेड टू अदर साइड ऑफ द स्टेट. तो वो देखिए, इफ सपोज दिस इज अ पर्टिकुलर स्टेट बाउंड्री, ओके, स्टेट बाउंड्री, एंड दिस इज अनदर स्टेट बाउंड्री. सी, रिवर इज नॉट लाइक अ हाईवे, इट्स नॉट अ नेशनल हाईवे दैट इट विल ऑलवेज बी मूविंग स्ट्रेट. नो, इट इज अ नेचुरल थिंग, इट कैन गो इन एनी डिरेक्शन, इट कैन गो दिस वे ऑल्सो, इट कैन गो दिस वे ऑल्सो. सो इफ अगर ऐसा है कि रिवर इज द नेचुरल बाउंड्री बिटवीन टू स्टेट्स, सो वट एवर इज दिस साइड, दिस इज अ पर्टिकुलर स्टेट, और जो दूसरी साइड है वो दूसरा स्टेट है, तो देर इज ऑलवेज अ रिस्क कि वेन एवर द रिवर विल चेंज इट्स पाथ, द एग्रीकल्चर लैंड विल ऑटोमेटिकली गो टू अ डिफरेंट स्टेट्स. ओके, सो दिस इज अ वेरी कॉमन प्रॉब्लम विच द फार्मर्स ऑफ अवर एरिया यूज टू फेस एट द बॉर्डर प्लेस, एट यमुना बॉर्डर, पानीपत एंड यूपी बॉर्डर. ओके, सो सिमिलर टाइप ऑफ केस स्टडी इज गिवन इन योर चैप्टर ऑल्सो, इन योर एनसीईआरटी बुक. देयर इज अ रिवर इन साउथ इंडिया, ओके, हियर इज एट द टिप व्हाट, तमिलनाडु, and it's here it's suppose Kerala, okay, and here Karnataka. So there's a common river flowing between these two states and the name of the river is Kaveri. So many years back there was a water dispute between these two states. These are two very bigger states of India, there are huge states, huge population, and dispute was in such a way, Karnataka has also made a dam on the river on its side and Tamil Nadu has also made a dam on its side. But if suppose Karnataka blocks all the water of the river Kaveri, how will Tamil Nadu gets water to store? It will be getting dried up, and Kaveri is a good big water resource for Tamil Nadu state as well. So there was a dispute between these two states that was named by the name of what? Kaveri water dispute. Then at the end, this case was being taken by the highest court of India, that is Supreme Court of India. Supreme Court of India gave a judgment how to utilize the water of this river intelligently, which state will get how much share. Then the things became pretty normal. Okay, now the water is being distributed equally. So this is one of the example in which government has to intervene when it feels that its down machinery वो सही से काम नहीं कर रही है. तो central government या our what we say institutions like Supreme Court, the guardian of our constitution, they have to take care. Okay, now moving to the next topic, the last topic of your chapter, that is equality and justice. This equality and justice, the students, those who are in regular touch with their studies, we have read such topic in our previous chapter also, in your CT1. Okay, equality and justice. See, my dear students, equality can't be possible without justice, and justice can't be possible without equality. Unless and until entire citizen of India are being catered equally, जब तक उनको सबको एक समान निगाहों से नहीं देखा जाएगा, नहीं treat करा जाएगा, you can't ensure justice in the country. Okay, there are many examples like gender. Okay, gender inequalities are there, rich and poor inequalities are there, caste based inequalities are there, religion based inequalities, there are many. Okay, dark and fair, डिस्क्रिमिनेशन बिटवीन डार्क एंड फेयर. सो दिस इक्वालिटी इज अ मैंडेटरी टूल ऑफ द सोसाइटी. इट शुड बी देयर. अनलेस एंड अंटिल इक्वालिटी इज देयर, यू कॉन्ट एंश्योर जस्टिस. ओके, देयर शुड बी नो इनइक्वालिटी इन केस ऑफ जॉब अपॉर्चुनिटीज. लाइक इफ यू आर ऑफरिंग अ जॉब, इट शुड बी equal to both boys and equal to girls. I will discuss a small subtopic in this category. Since India was under the British rule, there was one very bad social practice which was more prevalent in their time, British India time, that was untouchability. What was that? Untouchability. And untouchability was a social evil which created a huge gap between the higher class and the lower class. Okay, then one of our national leader, Dr. Bhim Rao Ambedkar ya Baba Sahib Ambedkar, fought vigilantly for this marginalized class, for this community, okay, for this scheduled caste community, to get this practice out of Indian culture. Okay, this practice is abolished by the law. Untouchability is abolished by the law. He struggled for many, many years for outdating this practice. Now, up to certain extent, this practice is now no more there in India. This untouchability against give birth to what? Inequality. Okay, so this is what entire thing there in your chapter. What a democratic government has to do for its citizen, what are the ways, how can we keep our demands in front of government through various tools in a peaceful way, what all government can do, what are its power. This was the thing. I would expect you to have a reading of this chapter. Again, thorough reading of this chapter, you go through your notes, means the question answers which will be provided by your teachers, subject teachers who will be taking your lesson. If at all, if you have any doubt regarding this chapter, you can share with your subject teacher. You can, of course, ask to them. Thank you.